In this video, we will go through how to use Cura. Make sure you have completed the steps in the Configuring Cura video before continuing with this video. Okay, in Cura, we generally work from left to right. So we would import our .stl files. We would choose the type of printer that we want to use, either the smaller Ultimaker 2 Plus, or we've also set it up for the larger 2 Plus Extended. I'm going to use the 2 Plus. Here, we would choose what nozzle type we would want to use. A finer 0.4 is what most of the machines have, but we also provide a faster, cruder 0.6 nozzle. And over here, we're able to get more settings by clicking on Custom, and we can choose those profiles that we downloaded in the previous video. This N04 stands for nozzle 0.4. So in this case, I couldn't use this profile because I have a 0.6 nozzle selected. The only profiles I can use are the ones with the N06. After that, we have a dash 0.35 or a dash 0.44, and this corresponds to the layer height. The larger the number, the quicker the print's going to be, and therefore it'll be cheaper. So down here with this profile, this would be the quickest, crudest way to print. With the 0.4 nozzle, this would be the finest, most expensive way to print. To start with, we open up our files. Click on this folder, and we can click the Shift key and select more than one file. Click Open, and those files are arranged on the platform. We're in the Prepare tab. We can click on Model, and then that allows us to move the objects around, or you can just drag them around. You can also scale, although it's best that you have the object already scaled before you bring it in. We can rotate. And this button here is really useful under the Rotate tab. It's the Lay Flat button. It's best if our objects are laying nice and flat on the platform, but sometimes you will have an object that is perhaps slightly on an angle. If you get it close to where you want it to lay flat and you click on the Lay Flat button, it'll make it nice and flat on the platform. It looks like these two objects are touching each other. If I go Auto Arrange All Model or Control R, it'll arrange those models nicely so that they're on the platform in a nice position. We also have the mirror button, which isn't used so much, per model settings, which would allow you to have multiple settings per print job. I'm not going to go into that in this tutorial. And then there's also a support blocker if you don't want supports in a certain area. All right, working from left to right. I've chosen that to use the Ultimaker 2 Plus, which is the smaller of the printers. Looks like my job will fit. And I'm going to use a 0.6 nozzle. I'm just blocking out these buildings for a model, so I don't really need them to be very high quality. Also, this building doesn't have gentle curves, so you won't notice the coarse setting with the 0.6 nozzle and the large layer height. And then over here, I am in the Customs tab. I'm going to choose that profile that we downloaded. It'll be under here. And because I'm using a 0.6 nozzle, I can only use one of these two. I'm going to go with this bottom profile with a 0.6 nozzle. In here, there are a lot more settings that you can tinker with. I won't be going into that in this tutorial. Most of the time, the settings that we've given you under the profile that you've downloaded will be fine. You do want to make sure that you have supports turned on. So under the Supports tab, make sure that's turned on. Okay, ready to slice. Clicking Slice. Once it's sliced, we can click the Preview button here, or the same thing here, Preview, and it shows us the G-code simulation. We can use this slider to see layer by layer what's created. I like to change the material color to to line type. And now I can see that in blue are the helpers or the support. Here we have the blue is the brim, is also classified as a helper to help it print properly. Underneath we can see that it's nice and flat on the platform and that should print successfully. All right, I'm now going to upload this to 3D Printer OS. And to do that, I could click on the Upload to 3D Printer OS tab if I've downloaded it from the marketplace. Or I could also just save it to file and then upload it through the website. I'm going to do the longer way, which is save to file. Here I'm going to name it. Now, it's important that you name the file with the printer that you're going to use and the nozzle that you're going to use. That way we can check as a technician, and it will also help you know that you're putting it on the right machine. It automatically names it UM2 and then your file name. So let's use that UM2, which is the Ultimaker 2, and then just add an N, and the nozzle that we're using over here, I can see I sliced it with an N06, so that would be N06. If you use the Ultimaker 2 Plus Extended, this would be a 2, and there would be an E in there for E for extended. But we're using the Ultimaker 2. I'm going to save that and now go to my 3D Printer OS account. I've already logged in and I have a balance, so I'll be able to print. To make your balance higher, you'll need to come into the BMAF office and pay with your SidPay card. Click on the upload button. And here you're given an option of a single file or a project. The single file will put it into the root directory. A project is basically a subfolder. I am doing this for a subject, so I'm going to put in a project. And the subject is Studio 3. I then choose that file. And I believe it was this one, UM2 N06. Open that. Okay, it's downloaded the G-code file. That's the type of file that the printer reads. And this is good. It says Cura. If it doesn't say Cura here, you may need to go back to the configuring Cura video and make sure your settings are right. It's probably not running the Marlin flavor, so that does need to say Cura. Here, this is the type of printer that we're using. So I'm using an Ultimaker 2, and so here, this is the correct printer. If this said UM2E for the Ultimaker 2 Plus Extended, then you would need to change this to the Ultimaker 2 Plus Extended. It doesn't know that automatically, so you do need to change it at this point. It will only show you the printers that are correct in this tab. All right, save and go to my projects. This print is going to cost me $17.52. It's going to take almost 3 hours to print. Over here, we have a preview of what that print looks like from the top. We could click on preview, and that would give us the G-code preview. I'm confident that it's okay because I saw it before in here. And so I'm going to click on print. Now, at this point, it's important that you choose only the printers to print on with the nozzle size that you have. This is an N06, and so I can put it on this machine, but not this machine. This has a 0.4 nozzle. If I put this file on this machine, I could damage it because it's expecting a larger nozzle than what this machine has. I can choose the color, black, white. I'm going to go with white. I'm just going to check that the printer is clear. Looks like it's clear, and it does have the nozzle that I'm expecting, which is a 0.6. Click on print. This window will take about 5 to 10 minutes before you'll see some movement in there. First, the heated bed platform will heat up to about 60 degrees, and then the extruder will heat up to about 200 degrees before moving. The printer's started, and the first layer looks like it's coming out. If it wasn't, I could always cancel the job. The first layers are probably the most risky. If it doesn't stick to the platform, it probably won't be a successful print. It's your responsibility to keep an eye on the print to make sure that it is printing successfully. A failed print could actually damage the machine. Please keep an eye on it. You will receive emails from 3D Printer OS telling you when your job has started and when it's finished, and you'll even receive a little video of a time lapse of it being printed. Among those emails, you'll also receive some notifications from us if we've cancelled the job or we think you need to resubmit. Please keep a lookout for those emails. I'm going to continue this in the background. I could always find it again by going to the dashboard, going to my printer history, and I could see here that I actually have a print in progress on the Blueberry machine. I go to the printers and find the Blueberry machine. I can go back to that live view.